As many Game of Thrones fans might know, winter is coming, and these are the top 5 tips that you need to know if you've got an electric car to get ready for winter. And by the way, if you're not already a subscriber, go and click subscribe down below, and if you click that notification bell if you are a subscriber, you'll be notified every time I make a new video. One of the greatest advantages of owning an EV is, unlike a petrol car or a diesel car or any normal combustion car, you don't have to wait for it to heat up. There's no engine to get warm. Heat is instant, and on pretty much nearly every single decent EV sold today, there's a little button on your key that preheats the car. Now, you can press that and preheat it, and also a lot of cars have preheat timers. This is the best thing about owning an EV, in my mind, that one of the few advantages that people don't see until they own one. So if you've got preheat on your car, preset up the preheat timers for every morning, preset the app if you've got an app to preheat your car. So if you're walking back from your car from your office at the end of the day and it's frozen, you can just preheat it before you get there. This will save you time from scraping the ice and also just sitting in a cold car. So set it up. Now the next one you'll be used to on a normal car, and that is the washer fluid. A couple of important things to tell you about washer fluid. If you didn't already know from having a nice car, use washer fluid. Never use anything else. There's a couple of reasons. Other things clog up the pipes. They get stuck in the pipes. So the worst thing you can do is put fairy washing up liquid, because it gels and sticks in the pipes, and it basically means it's going to cost you a lot of money unblocking all these channels inside the jets. Use proper washer fluid. All washer fluid you buy will be either concentrated or pre-mixed. If it's a concentrated variety like this one, on the back of the label here, it'll tell you the concentration you need for summer and winter. Mix it to the correct concentration. The other reason for this is, on a cold day, this has got antifreeze in, so it will stop the water basically freezing your washer jet. So if you've ever had that time where your washer jets aren't working because they're frozen, it's because you didn't mix this concentrate correctly. If you mix this correctly, it won't ice up. Now, once you've mixed it, make sure you actually use your washer jets and pull through that liquid with that new concentration fluid, because if you haven't used your washer jets for a while, you'll still have quite a weak concentration in there, and you want to pull through this concentrated mixture, and it'll ensure that the jets don't get blocked up and they're all free. It's also good to check that none of them are clogged with dirt or holes or anything like that, and they're all angling correctly. And while you're doing that, you can check your wipers. Make sure your wipers are clearing the screen correctly, because you might as well get all that ready for winter, because it's going to get dirty, it's going to get gritty. This is probably one that you've not thought of. I'm demonstrating this on the Renault Zoe, but this applies to pretty much all EVs. The one thing you really want to make sure, this little thing here, which is your charge flap, you want to make sure that it's basically opening, closing, and it's free from moisture around any plastic seals. Now, you can clean the plastic seals from a couple of ways. I like to use WD-40. According to WD-40, it's safe to use in plastics. I often see people say don't use it on plastics. I've yet to have a plastic snap, break, or be damaged by WD-40. So I like to spray a little bit lightly all over. I also have some plastic rubber cleaner. All links are down below in the description if you want to use any of the ones I use. But just wipe around the plastics and make sure they're free of moisture. The reason you want to make sure they're free of moisture is, in the winter, what you might find is when it gets cold and ices up, these charge flaps can freeze shut. And the last thing you want to do is have it freeze shut and panic when you're at a rapid charge and you want to get your plug in. So just make sure it's all free of moisture, it's cleaned up, and it's nice and sort of free of dirt, because that's the other thing that can help trap moisture in any dirt in the rubber seal. So give it a good clean around the rubber seals, drive any moisture out. Now, you may ask, what about moisture in the actual pins? Personally, you don't often see any damage to the pins, so I'd leave them alone. If you're really, really, really concerned that the pins are getting dirty, rusty, full of moisture, then you can either buy some contact cleaner, which is rated at 440 volts or plus, and you can just basically just spray contact cleaner in there and leave it to dry. Personally, I'd leave it alone. If you're really that worried, find a HEVRA recommended garage and have them clean out the pins for you. Mainly, I just leave the pins completely alone. If there's a fault with the pins, you'll have an earthing fault and the car won't just charge. So you'll tend to know way before the winter. Water, moisture, freezing and stuff not going to affect them any more than damp weather. So you would have already had the problems sort of coming up to autumn. But make sure this charge flap's nice and free. If it ever does get stuck when you're out and about and you forgot to do this and you're panicking, on the Renault Zoes you can just keep pushing them and opening and pushing and opening and pushing, and eventually they'll free off. If it's a BMW, then there's an emergency pull cord. There's a video on the top right of my channel on where the emergency pull is in case that's frozen. But basically, just make sure your charge flap's opening freely, closing freely, and it's free of any moisture buildup that might make it freeze in the winter. Now, if this is your first year owning an EV, you won't know this, but if you're an existing EV owner and who's had an EV for a couple of years, you'll already know about this, and that is your range will be seriously affected by the cold weather. There is a range drop. You need to know that your car will do less range when it is cold. Bit similar to a petrol ICE car does less miles per gallon in the winter, a electric car when you're using or your heater or your lights, and the battery has a lower storage capacity, it doesn't store as much energy when it is cold, and for these reasons there is a range drop. Now, I have listed down below in the description a website called evdata.com that has all the data that you need for the worst case, minus 15 winters, so the absolute worst case scenario in the cold, and then obviously the best case in the summer. Now, they are worst cases. You should get better than that. Rule of thumb, 22 kilowatt battery Zoe. If you're doing motorway driving, you're gonna get 60 in the winter, and most people get around 75, 80 in the winter, but it depends on your driving style, what type of driving. You are gonna get a range drop, so you need to factor this in if you're gonna be doing long trips, lots of charging, or you've got a relatively long commute. So you need to factor in that there will be a range drop, and you need to take precautions for that and ensure that you have enough range available. The other thing to remember is that Teslas, for example, the Model 3, if you're or a Model 3 Plus or your Model 3 Standard, then if you're only charging to that 80% range, you're gonna have a drop on that 80% range as well. So you might wanna top up to maybe 90% just to try and make up some of that difference. Now, although you've got a 440 volt system in your car, or maybe an 800 volt system like the new Porsche Taycan, those 22 kilowatt hour batteries, 40 kilowatt hour batteries, 60, 90 kilowatt hour batteries, they are fantastic lithium batteries, very, very good at sort of looking after themselves, got a BMS system, fairly decent sort of low sort of cutoff points on the SOH. However, at the front of the car or the back of your car, you will have a standard 12 volt lead acid battery. That is rubbish. It doesn't like the hot, it doesn't like the cold, it likes to be Goldilocks, and they don't last very long. Typically, most service people recommend that you replace these on, for example, the Renault Zoe, I think after 3 years. BMW, I think, is a 4 year life battery. Nissan Leaf, I think, is also similar on a 3 year battery. So these 12 volt systems do not like to be sort of long term, and they're constantly being fully charged, which, as we know, being a high state of charge all the time is not good for battery life. The problem is when you come to the winter, if this is dead, you probably find that you can't start your car. Now, there is a DC to DC conversion system that tops this 12 volt battery system up and keeps it healthy. And that works on a BMW i3, it pretty much tops it up all the time and ensures it's in optimal health. On the Renault Zoe, for example, it doesn't. It only tops up this 12 volt system when the car's woken up. So doors open, preheat kicks in, something like that. So if you're going to leave this car stood for a matter of 4, 5, 6, maybe a week, you might just want to just open the door, even if you're not taking the car out, just to top this 12 volt system up, just to make sure it doesn't go flat. Because if it is near its end of its life, it may go flat after 2 days, and then in which case, you'll be calling the RAC or someone similar to come and replace your car. Now, there is a jump pack down below in the description, which is a lithium pocket size jump pack that you can use on this system if it is very, very low. But bear in mind that really what you should be doing is keeping this topped up, and you can buy various trickle chargers to keep this topped up as well. So there is a link of them down below in the description as well. The links down below in the description are Amazon links. Amazon pay me a referral if you do buy anything through any of my links on bottom of my videos. And there's also various links for Octopus Energy, Octopus Electric Vehicles, if you're going to do a leasing deal. They're all down there. Like I said, fair and honest, I get a kickback off these. Doesn't cost you anything. If you buy for the Amazon link, it costs you exactly the same money as if you went direct. They just give me a small contribution, which goes towards buying equipment for the channel and stuff like that. But while we're on that, thank you very much to all my patrons whose support has been fantastic. They've enabled some of the amazing things that have happened on the channel recently. And I thank you. If you haven't already, please go and click subscribe. If you've enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family. Help the EV future grow and get people into electric cars. Thanks very much for watching this week, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye.